This program was paid for by Water of Life Church. From Water of Life Ministries in Plano, Texas, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is speaking through his servants to the world. He that hath ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying today. Let us join Doyle Davidson and others of Water of Life, sowing the Word of God in spirit and in truth.
Hello, I'm Doyle Davidson, servant and apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ, ministering locally to the body of Christ in Dallas, Fort Worth, Texas, sent by God to your house to declare unto you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15, 3 and 4, tell us what the gospel is, how that Jesus Christ died for our sins, according to Scripture. He is buried. He rose again the third day, according to the Scripture. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, sent me to heal the brokenhearted, preach deliverance to the captives, giving sight to the blind, set at liberty them that are bruised. The word is nigh thee, even in your heart, in your mouth. There's a word of faith which I preach, you confess with your mouth, the Lord Jesus. And believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead. You shall be saved with the heart, man, believeth unto righteousness. With the mouth, confession, saved. Confession is made unto salvation. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. There's the power of God unto salvation. Everyone who believes, the Jew first, and also to the Greek. There is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by his faith. I want to welcome everyone to this broadcast, receiving it on live stream, Roku. Thank God. Apple TV, YouTube, and other devices. Thank God. Amen. McCall's, Kathie Davidson, to my left. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm doing well.
Good. We have a very interesting program today, and if you're wise, you won't want to miss it. Amen. We're going to have we got Terry Brown here?
Yes.
Yeah. We'll call her up after these songs.
Okay.
I got so much going on. Keeping things straight is a task. Let's have two songs, Terry By and Waterfly Boys, recorded by Terry in the 90s. Water of Life Boys and Terry in 2012. And Matt, two songs.
Fear and doubt come against your mind. Has your faith been sorely tried? Lift up your eyes, here cometh your help. It is Jesus, he has been. Rise and be healed in the name touch you and set you free. So rise and be healed in the name of Jesus. Let faith arise in your heart. Rise and
Jesus, He is your Lord. Hallelujah.
The Lord had told me in 2003, the last broadcast that I made, the power of darkness was coming upon my ministry in 2004. By April, it was evident. It was here. It was coming. And I made it. Many were scattered. We'll be talking about that. Almost everybody was scattered. Not completely. But in 2009, God brought KD to me from Briscoe. In 2010, he brought Terry Brown to join us, and we were praying. KD and I and Terry joined us. I believe it was the day my daughter was, and she joined us. God gave me a scripture. Matthew 18:20. Would you read it?
Sure will. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them.
That's what the Lord said to me. He put us, the three of us together, to be in our midst when we gather together in his name. Jerry Brown said a lot of things happened since then, so have I, so has Kathie D. Terry's coming forth with great ministry songs, power, faith, Holy Ghost. Here she is now, and that's what the cross is for. Terry Brown.
Your mind confused and cluttered. Life has your back against the wall. Mercy's been there in the shadows. Your heart won't let him in at all. There's a cross of pain where Jesus bore all the burden of your sin. A place where dying deep inside, new life wells up again. He wants to ease your pain. Eternal life you'll gain. He's standing by your door. That's what the cross is for. Oh, my friend, I've been where you are, lost in that cold and lonely place. Mind is filled with such despair, pain is etched upon your face. Listen to the answer, is the cross you'll find Jesus there. It's true, oh, I too was lost, I've been set free. He'll do the same for you.
Spirit. Kathie.
Yes, sir.
How are you?
Doing well.
I guess I should lead off.
Yes.
Since our script is in heaven, we better follow it, huh?
Amen.
In the 1970s, God told me, when I was in Argyle, he gave me a ministry like his sons. That was far out from me. I didn't understand how that could be. Not at all. But I never forgot it. It was in my heart. In my spirit, kept there. Since those days, much has changed. 2003, God told me darkness was going to hit my ministry. Come upon it, just like it did Jesus. That day, I think I started accepting that I had a ministry more like Jesus than I had previously. I had warned the people more than once on television, radio. I was ready for God to inspect this place. Are you? Are you? That would be my question. I'm not afraid for the Lord to inspect this place. Are you? Are you afraid? Are you ready for him to inspect it? Well, on board it came. No question. People were shocked. I came under great attack of the devil, power of darkness. I moved to Plano, July 1st, 04, from Fairview. Trouble. Every day I was here, trouble met me. Amen. I've come to see divination. The devil in divination met me. Flattering divination caused me much trouble, both male and female. It's amazing what came down. People left. They were scattered, just like the days of Jesus. They were scattered. They went every direction. Some went away with an agenda to bring me down. Some even told me, you're going to die. Your ministry's going to fall. I wanted to pray. I had a newspaper man call me once from a prominent newspaper, very prominent. He said, does it bother you to be in the cross eyes? No, it doesn't. It doesn't bother you that you're right. They've got you.
Crosshairs.
Oh, it is crosshairs.
Crosshairs.
Thank you. Yeah. They've got you there. They're shooting at you. old rival woman here. Not old. Pardon me.
Yeah, what's just the wife. Right.
Okay. No, it doesn't bother me. I put myself there. I could have hit. But he said it bothers me. It bothers me to treat you like we're treating you. I said, don't let it bother you, friend. I forgive every one of you. That was an interesting phone call, you know that?
Amen.
That newspaper man's conscience was bothering me. Bothering me. Most don't have a conscience. He did. I said, don't let it bother you. I'm fine. But people left Water of Life. Long time friends and acquaintance. The first person that I met in the charismatic movement was Jack Turquette. Jack Turquette was at Christ for a Nation. He had sent it. He started joining me in beginning in my meeting. Another one, I guess I better say, the first one was Dale Littrell and Sharon. Sharon's in heaven, Dale's in McKinney. Then Jack Turquette. Of course, I'd met Bruce Gehr too. So those three were with me through the early days in McKinney. First United Methodist Church. Dale was with me. Jack Turquette. Amen. When I came to Plano, Jack had a prophecy for me in 1980. I think it was June when the prophecy came. He said, I have a prophecy for you. Why'd you give it? Too hard. Too hard? Yeah. I said, well, tell me. Tell me. He said, well, it said, wicked men are waiting for you in Plano. Good. I was waiting for them. Amen. Well, when darkness hit, many left me. And I wasn't sure what would happen to all of them. Africa, Mexico, America, U.S. of A. Said, he's in sin. Wrong. He's finished. It's over. Let's go. Back to our denominational churches or somewhere. No, I wasn't done. I bought on. And they almost the last left. Not all. 2009, Jeremiah went to heaven. wasn't funny, wasn't easy. People would take what God told me to say and say it was sin. No, it wasn't sin. Wasn't sin at all. Did you know God can tell somebody to speak something that you would call sin and it's not? Well, that's what happened. And they ran like rats off a sinking ship. Pardon me. You'll have to forgive me. I've forgiven you 100 times. The wicked things that were said about me, to me. And, you know, the great bloggers that bear so great on earth, they'd say anything. But the matter was true, they'd say it. So you're talking about, are you a blogger? I'm talking about you. Amen. Amen. What do you think, Katie?
I'm just smiling away.
You are?
Yeah.
Amen. Thank God. Amen. Thank God. They would say anything to try to destroy me. None of them touched me. None of them. I laughed all the way through all their accusations. Thank God. Recently, just recently, I could see that God was going to tell them that he gave them to my ministry, and he didn't give them to any other ministry. Amen. I started getting excited. I love every one of them. And thousands in Africa. Thousands. In Africa. America. I don't even know how many tapes I gave away in the U.S. of A. But a lot of them. Pray. And babe ready. You know what? You didn't believe anything you heard. You didn't believe it. You did not believe it. And with that darkness, it did scatter you people. What time is it?
It is 11:31.
It did scatter you. Several days back, I started saying, the Lord only had 120. He sent out 12. He sent out 70 to preach the gospel. I said, what, Luke 9 or is that 10? I think it's 9, 70 to preach the gospel. And 12 and then 70 on the day of Pentecost. You know that? 120.
Right. About 120.
About 120?
Right.
Thank you. About. Have you found where's that?
Where he sent the 70 out?
Well, forget it. One of them is the first verse of some chapter. Another is the 19th verse of another chapter. That's the 70. Thank God, I think. I know.
Luke 10 is about 70.
Is it 10?
That's what I thought.
Thank you.
It says Luke 10, verse 1. After these things, the Lord appointed other 70 also and sent them two and two before his face into every city and place whither he himself would come.
Amen. So, on the day of Pentecost, Jesus just had about, the woman tells me. See, I can't see the Bible.
I know.
Been over 8 years since I've read very much. I read some on a tablet. But 70, 12, and about 120. That's all he had.
Can I say something here?
Why not?
He had the 12 apostles, which he sent out, and they cast out devils, and they healed the sick.
Right.
They walked in that power.
Right.
He sent out the 70.
Right.
And they cast out devils. They right. healed the sick. They walked in the power.
Right.
And I will read Matthew 26:31. And then Jesus said unto them about the power of darkness. He said, all you shall be offended because of me this night. They're offended. For it is written, I will smite the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock shall be scattered abroad.
Did I not say in my recording last Sunday, 03, that many would be offended?
Amen.
I mentioned two people were relatives.
Right.
That things were possible, they'd be offended. You know, neither one of them are with me.
Yes, I know. You know, Jesus said in another place, he said, the power of darkness has come and no man can work.
Right.
He said, when that power hit.
Amen. Thank God. It's been grievous. Hearts grieve. But now, God is speaking through me, calling them back. All are getting the call that were with me. All will all make it back. You follow me?
I follow you.
How'd you like the way God put that? All are called. Will they all make it? Would you read John 17?
Sure will. I'll read in verse 6, John 17, verse 6. It says, I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were, and thou gavest them me, and they have kept thy word. I'm going to keep reading because it goes on. It says, now they have known that all things whatsoever thou hast are given me are of thee. For I have given unto them the words which thou gavest me, and they have received them. And have known surely that I came out from thee, and they have believed that thou didst send me. I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast given me, for they are thine. And all mine are thine, and thine are mine, and I am glorified in them. And now I am no more in the world, but these are in the world, and I come to thee. Holy Father, keep through thine own name those whom thou hast given me, that they may be one as we are. While I was with them in the world, I kept them in thy name. Those that thou gavest me, I have kept, and none of them is lost, but the son of perdition, that the scripture might be fulfilled.
Hello?
You want me to go on?
Yes, I want to go on.
Okay. And now come I to thee, and these things I speak in the world, that they might have my joy fulfilled in themselves. I have given them thy word, and the world has hated them, because they are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. I pray not that thou shouldest take them out of the world, but thou should keep them from the evil. They are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. Sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth. As thou hast sent me into the world, even so have I sent them into the world. And for their sakes I sanctify myself, that they also might be sanctified through the truth. Neither pray I for these alone, but for them also which shall believe on me through their word, that they may all be made one, as thou, Father, art in me, and I in thee, that they also may be one in us, that the world may believe that thou hast sent me. And the glory which thou gavest me, I have given them, that they may be one, even as we are one. I in them, and thou in me, that they may be made perfect in one, that the world may know that thou hast sent me, and hast loved them as thou hast loved me. Father, I will that they also, whom thou hast given me, be with me where I am, that they may behold my glory, which thou hast given me, for thou lovest me before the foundation of the world. O righteous Father, the world hath not known thee, but I have known thee, and these have known that thou hast sent me. And I have declared unto them thy name, and will declare it, that the love wherewith thou hast loved me may be in them, and I in them. End of chapter.
I just realized that Jesus only sanctified about 120.
Right.
Right?
Right.
Amazing. A couple years ago, God started me praying to sanctify
Amen.
People. Would you read Acts 26?
Sure will.
Yeah, 26.
Acts 26.
Amen. Thank God. They got it back. They got it back. Thank God.
Acts 26, and I'll begin at 13. At midday, O king, I saw in the way a light from heaven, above the brightness of the sun, shining round about me and them which journeyed with me. And when we were all fallen to the earth, I heard a voice speaking unto me and saying in the Hebrew tongue, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks. And I said, Who art thou, Lord? And he said, I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest. But rise and stand upon thy feet, for I have appeared unto thee for this purpose, to make thee a minister and a witness, both of these things which thou hast seen, and of those things in which I will appear unto thee, delivering thee from the people and from the Gentiles, unto whom now I send thee, to open their eyes, and to turn them from darkness to light, and from the power of Satan unto God, that they may receive forgiveness of sins and inheritance among them which are sanctified, by faith that is in me.
Pat, my wife, God told me to marry in 1952. Certainly suffered from 84 to 2003 when she went to heaven. One thing I'm confident of, I kept her in my house. I wouldn't put her in a nursing home. Took care of her myself and prayed for her. One day, she said, No, thank God for you. If you hadn't prayed, believe God and prayed, we'd all gone to hell.
Amen.
But you know, I'm convinced the Lord sanctified Betty.
Amen.
Through my faith, Kathie, our daughter, and me were standing in a room when she went to heaven, and she opened her eyes, waved twice, she left. She's a person, and she should have been.
Amen.
You know?
Yeah.
Tell me about where you went to heaven.
Amen.
I spent several days, an hour or so, whatever it took, dealing with him. And I'm convinced he's sanctified, set apart to God.
Amen.
Now, others are being sanctified, have been, you, Jerry, others that I pray for, the men on staff, sheriff, others that watch my broadcast.
Amen.
That give money to this ministry, watches.
It's a joy to hear them and how God's sanctifying them.
Right, right. Can you think of anyone else that I've overlooked?
Well, I know for a fact, through you and me, God sanctified Bernadette before she went to heaven.
Oh, without a doubt.
Absolutely. That girl was ready to go.
Bernadette Boschel.
Yeah.
France. Went to Water of Life Christian Training School.
Right.
No question anymore that you can think of. Oh, Lord, those that we're not mentioning, it's because we don't remember.
Terry Brown's mother, Jane.
Oh, thank you. I've watched Terry's mother because of persecution, because of her faith, come under great affliction, affected her mind. She left Water of Life. She left Water of Life. I never stopped praying for her. She was on several medications. Before she went to heaven, I know she was not on any medication except one, a diuretic. What'd she say?
For a while, none.
Oh, okay. Terry said, for a while, none. We watched, I did, Terry watched, told me what was going on daily in the room. I said, God is sanctifying Jane. And I knew she was going to heaven. And I knew when she was ready. God sanctified. Sanctified Terry's mother.
Amen.
Now, anybody else? Thank you for remembering that.
Thank Terry.
Terry do it?
Yeah.
Well, thank God. She knows. What time?
It is 11:46.
46?
Mm-hmm.
Well, let me just say, I don't know how many of you will make it back. I'd be happy. It'd be about 120.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
But God knows I don't. He knows whether you love the world more than him. He knows what kind of sin you're in. And you can't turn it loose. You won't leave your sin behind. I heard his testimony once about a young man had a problem. He told a friend of mine he had the problem. He said, I'd rather enjoy it. You think God will forgive me? The friend of mine said, No, he won't forgive you till you humble yourself and ask. I really enjoy it. I don't know. I can't let it go. I've seen more than one can't let their sins go. Amen. They're pleasures. My friends, you need to lay it down. You need to lay it down. And if you've been a Water of Life person that the gospel has been preached to, you need to come back and not necessarily come to this building, but back on television. And let me say something boldly. If you come back, you come back giving some money. I've taught this all these years. A person that is faithful with their money will be faithful to God. But if you have set your heart on your riches, I pray that God grants you the grace to come back, give up your riches, your heart on them, and do what God had you do it, and that's giving to Water of Life Ministry. Otherwise, you won't be back. Where are we at?
49.
You got anything to say?
I have something here to minister if we have time.
Speak.
All right. We're talking about this Jesus. Before I go into this, I want to read us a verse in 1 Corinthians 6:17. It says, "But he that is joined unto the Lord is one spirit."
Right.
So if you are born again, this same spirit in Jesus that I'm going to minister today is in you, is in you.
Amen.
And he can work through you just like he did with himself. If you would turn with me to John 10, verse 17, where you're going to talk about this Jesus that was on the cross. We talked about the other day about him in the garden, and then we talked about him on the cross and what happened to his body. Now I'm going to show you what happened with his spirit. I will show you in verse, John 10, 17. We're going to see Jesus on the cross. It says, "Therefore does my Father love me, because I lay down my life, that I might take it again." And I want you to look at this next phrase, "No man taketh it from me." Do you see that Jesus said here, no man is going to kill me. No man can kill me. He said, "No man taketh my life from me, but I lay it down in myself." He said, "I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again." He has power to die. He has the power now to die, and he has the power to become alive again. And where did he get it? He said, "This commandment have I received of my Father." Do you know that if the Father hadn't given him this commandment, he could not have done that?
Amen.
It was by the commandment of God that Jesus did this. Now I want us to turn to John 19. John 19, verse 10, this is Jesus in front of Pilate, and he makes a statement here that's astounding. "Then said Pilate unto him, Speakest thou not unto me? He said, Knowest thou not that I have power to crucify thee, and I have power to release thee? And Jesus answered," look what he said,
"Amen.
Thou couldest have no power at all against me. Thou couldest have no power at all against me, except it were given to thee from above. Therefore, thou that deliverest me unto thee has the greater sin." Do you see what Jesus said here? "You have no power against me, Pilate, except what the Father lets happen." You know, we were talking just a little bit ago about the darkness hitting Water of Life. It happened the same that way there too.
Amen.
No power could have come on this church except God allow it.
God.
And he did. And he did. It says, "I could have no power at all against me." Now, turn with me to Mark 15. I'm going to go to verse 22. This is Jesus on the cross.
Amen.
Now remember, Jesus said, "I have the power to lay down my life. No man can take it from me." So, Mark 15, verse 22. "And they bring him unto the place Golgotha, which is being interpreted the place of a skull. And they gave him to drink wine mingled with myrrh, but he received it not. Now remember, this man, Jesus, this God that had to become a man, we've talked about this. He was God, but he humbled himself and became a man. And now he has been nailed to the cross. Now he has been scourged by the Romans. He has had his beard plucked out. He has been beaten with rods. And now he's on the cross. And they offer him wine mingled with myrrh, but he would not take it. If you will let me, I'm going to read from Psalm 69, verse 21. This is Jesus out of the prophet David. He said, they gave me also gall for my meat, and in my thirst, they gave me vinegar to drink. Notice, Jesus here said, they gave me vinegar to drink, not vinegar mixed with gall. Jesus refused it. Do you see the power, the strength of the Spirit in him? Amen. The strength of the Spirit of Jesus, not Jesus' physical strength. Jesus didn't have any. In Psalm 22, Amen. He goes on and he says, I have no strength. Where was the strength? His strength was in his Spirit. His strength was in his Spirit. You know that Spirit's in you if you're born again?
Amen.
He says, and they gave him to drink wine mingled with myrrh, but he received it not. And when they had crucified him, they parted his garments among them, what every man should take. And it was the third hour, and they crucified him. And if you will go down to verse 33, and it says, and when the sixth hour was come, he said, there was darkness over the land, whole land until the ninth hour. And at the ninth hour, 9 hours, or from 3 to 9, 6 hours on the cross. He says, and at the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, which is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? This is when the Father turned his back on Jesus. And if you will read and listen to what we ministered just a couple days ago, that body of Jesus now is broken. That body, every bone is out of joint. He is marred more than any man. And he is in that state when he said, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. His body is broken. And he said, my God, why have you forsaken me? You know why? He had your sin on him. He took, the Father laid your sin on Jesus. And that's when he said, my Eli, Eli. And then he said, and some of them that stood by when they heard it said, behold, he calleth for Elias. And one man ran and filled a sponge full of vinegar and put it on a reed and gave him to drink. And then they said, let him alone. Let's see whether Elias will come and take him down. And it says here in Mark, and Jesus cried with a loud voice and he gave up the ghost. He gave up the ghost. Amen. He did not die. They did not kill him. They didn't kill him. The Roman soldiers with the scourge couldn't kill him. Every bone out of joint couldn't kill him. Marred more than any man couldn't kill him. He gave up the ghost. He had that authority. He got that from a commandment from the Father. I can lay my life down and I can pick it up. And here he lays it down. If you will turn with me to Matthew 27, verse 50. It says, and Jesus, when he had cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the ghost. He yielded up the ghost. They couldn't take it from him. He yielded it up. In Luke 23, 46, it says, and when Jesus had cried with a loud voice, he said, Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit. And having Amen. Said that, he gave up the ghost.
Amen.
Gave it up. And I will go to John 19. In John 19, verse 28, and after this, Jesus, knowing that all things are now accomplished, that the scripture might be fulfilled. Look at the man on the cross, every bone out of joint, no strength, beaten, scorched, and he has the strength to see that there's one more thing he's got to do. The strength to see he's got one more thing to do. And what does he say? So after this, Jesus, knowing all things are now accomplished, that the scripture might be fulfilled, said, I thirst. And they set a vessel full of vinegar, and they filled a sponge with the vinegar, and he put it on hyssop and put it to his mouth. And when he knew that everything he had to accomplish on that cross was done, when the Spirit of Jesus knew that everything that had to be accomplished on that cross was done. What did he say? He said, it's finished. It is finished. It is finished. And he bowed his head and gave up the ghost. That is the spirit of Jesus. That is the spirit that's in us. That is the spirit that's in us. He could handle the cross, and he can handle anything that God puts in front of us when he's in us. And we have a minute and a half left.
What's Luke 16:10 say?
All right. Luke 16:10 says, he that is faithful in that which is least is faithful also in much, and he that is unjust in the least is unjust also in much.
What's 8 say? 8, 9, and 10.
The Lord commendeth the unjust steward because he had done wisely, for the children of this world are in their generation wiser than the children of light. Verse 9, and I say unto you, make yourselves friends of the mammon of unrighteousness, that when you fail, you may receive you into everlasting habitations. 10. He that is faithful in that which is least is faithful also in much. He that is unjust in the least is unjust also in much. Verse 11. If therefore you have not been faithful in the unrighteous mammon, who will commit to your trust the true riches? 12. And if you have not been faithful in that which is another man's, who shall give you that which is your own?
There it is, folks. Faithful with money. Faithful with everything.
Amen.
Some of you thought you'd given enough, and you just decided you wanted to do something else with it. Sin. Sin of rebellion. Sin of rebellion. When you leave a work that God has set you in, you'll never obey God again till you return to what you left. God is the only one that can receive you back. Look, folks, you can listen to independent times and wicked people, wicked hearts, only want what they want. And they don't know that there's a place in eternity called hell, eternal punishment. Never stop. Never. It's scary for a person that knows to do good and do it, if not, it is sin. Father, I pray grace and mercy upon all these people, all that have believed my gospel, receive Jesus through the gospel, and have decided they don't want to go on, but they want to do something else. I pray that your mercy and grace will bring them back to this ministry where they started out with the gospel. God bless you. See you next time.
We invite you to visit Water of Life Church at 1621 18th Street in Plano, Texas. Or for further information, call area code 972-578-8082. That's 972-578-8082. Or write Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. That's Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. This program was paid for by Water of Life Church.